LH, can I eat beef? Please, please, please let me know. I'm 27, suffering from 2 days. Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Responding to Your Comments. What are we waiting for? Let's dive in. LH, this is a great comment. It's not a chickenpox video. I don't understand why you can't eat beef. There's no problem eating beef in chickenpox. Unless you have beef with beef, or the beef has beef with chickenpox. Yeah. So unless you have beef with beef, or the beef has beef with chickenpox, then you can't eat beef, but you can eat beef. Beef is fine. Unless you've got beef with beef, then don't eat beef. I've got to stop saying beef. MC Plays, I have a question too. Is it bad drinking coffee? MC Plays, thank you for your comment and question. This is a really good question. Do I drink coffee? Yeah, I drink coffee. Do a lot of healthcare professionals drink it? I'm pretty sure they do. So generally speaking, I don't really recommend children or anyone in high school really to drink coffee. Basically because you don't need it, you've already got loads of energy, and you're also going to build up a tolerance to it. Now, how much is safe? Generally speaking, 400 milligrams is said to be safe. It's said to be a safe amount. 400 milligrams of caffeine is about 4 cups of brewed coffee. But you need to be careful of this, because a lot of coffee shops and big chains, they make all these weird and wonderful coffees that have like extra espresso shots in them and 6x shots in them, all this sort of stuff. And that's gonna go way over the limit. So you need to be aware of that. Also, it's important to remember that caffeine does interact with a lot of medicines. So levothyroxine is one of them. So if anyone's watching this and they take loads of medicines or any medicines and they drink a lot of coffee as well, next time you're in the pharmacy, just check with your pharmacist as well so they can give you some advice on this. Crystal Estes, why you keep moving around? Lol, great video though. And then someone says underneath, it's good old fashioned hand trickery. Crystal, thank you for your comment. Actually, I just moved back there when I said that. I don't know. I really don't know. A lot of people have commented this. It's just something that I do. I've always been quite fidgety. I always move around quite a lot. I can't sit down for too long either. I always have to like stand up and walk around. I've just always been like this. Funny story actually, when I was in high school, I was really good friends with my English teacher, and she always used to say, Abraham, you need to stop fidgeting, you need to stop fidgeting, you need to stop moving, you need to stop talking. That was another thing she always used to say. And then she used to make me come and stand like in front of the whiteboard, I'd stand like this, and she'd draw like an outline of me, and I had to like stand in this sort of outline for like 5 minutes. Did it help? No, because I still sort of do this and rock around when I speak. But it was quite an interesting approach. Helena Hamamji. Hello, I'm Helena. I'm studying pharmacy in Belgium. I would be grateful if you could explain your study methods. Helena, thank you for your comment. This is a good question. So during the past 10 years, a pharmacy school, university, pre-registration, various different training and practice that I've done countless number of exams. And I have kind of mastered it for myself. But I think the most important thing to remember that these tips work for me. And everyone's different, so something might work for you that doesn't work for me, and something might work for me that doesn't work for you. But I think the most important thing to do, so tip number one, is start revising early, don't leave it to the last minute. And I always revise at a 30 to 5, that's what I call it, a 30 to 5. So 30 minutes revision, 5 minutes break. 30 minutes revision, 5 minutes break. It just gives you that nice little rest, and a kind of nice little routine to follow. Cramming and all-nighters aren't ideal. But have I done them? Yes, I've done them. Have other students done them? I'm sure loads of other students have done them. Sometimes in pharmacy school, there's not enough time to study, so you have to kind of do this. But again, it's not ideal. Also, I would also advise you not to use your bed for studying. A lot of people do this, but it's good to separate the two. The bed is just for sleeping, studying on the table, etc. And lastly, probably the most important advice I can give you is understand what you're studying. And I know that sounds very simple, but when I was on my pre-registration training at Guy's and St. Thomas's, my tutor was Amos Aftar, he's really well known in pharmacy. And he taught me, he always used to say to me, Abraham, why? Why does amlodipine work like this? Why does paracetamol work like this? Why do you say this? Why do you say take methotrexate weekly? All these different things. And he'd always question me why, and it's so important, because when you understand why, like I said in probably a few weeks ago in an episode responding to your comments, it's gonna take you to that next level, because patients will ask you why as well. So it's not just about kind of memorizing things and recalling it back. When you understand why, you understand exactly how it works, why it works, where it works, and it all just makes sense, and you'll remember it for probably the rest of your life. JCD, my breath was taking away watching this video. Very well done. JCD, thank you for your comment. Thank you for your nice words. This was on the how to use a spacer device video. Thank you. I mean, that's what I'm here for, to empower you with knowledge on how to use your inhaler, how to use a spacer device, and various other health and medical topics. So the fact that your breath was taken away makes me very happy. I mean, I hope your asthma is well controlled. I hope it's not because of the asthma, it's just because the video was so good, it took your breath away. Thank you for your comment. Jacqueline Ramirez, is hot tea with honey good too, since you said not to drink hot drinks? Jacqueline, thank you for your comment. There has been so much confusion about this hot drinks on my sore throat video. I actually did an article recently for The Guardian, where I contributed to it, about sore throats. I actually mentioned this hot drink thing too. So when I say avoid hot drinks, I mean avoid super duper hot water. So once your kettle is boiled and it's really, really hot and you poured your drink, don't start drinking at that point. It's really hot. It will make your sore throat worse. Let it cool down. Once it's cooled down a little, then you can mix it with your honey, like you said, your tea, whatever, and drink it. And that's the end of this week's Responding to Your Comments episode. I'm really loving the interaction that we've got going on YouTube. And if I didn't get back to your comment, then leave another comment and I'll try my best to get back to you in next week's episode. Please don't forget to subscribe, and click that bell button too, because it tells YouTube that you're enjoying my content and you want to see more. See you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.